Hello, everybody, and welcome back to your English lesson. And today we will be talking a little bit about grammar. So let's take a look at the examples that I have here. The telephone, which was invented by Alexander Graham Bell, a paperback, which was written by Stephen King, a play, which was written by William Shakespeare, the light bulb, which was invented by Thomas Edison, the DNA, which was discovered by James Watson and Francis Crick, and the law of gravity, which was discovered by Sir Isaac Newton. What do all these examples have in common? So they have in common that the subject of the sentence that I said is not doing the action. The subject here is actually receiving the action. So something is being done to the subject. So it is not the telephone which invented something, but the telephone was invented. It is not a play which wrote something. A play was written. So the subject is receiving the action. And this is something that we call the passive voice, the passive form, okay, of the verbs. And today we will be discussing the present simple passive and the past simple passive. So first of all, we want to know what is the passive voice. Okay, we have to know the difference between an active form and the passive form. So the active sentence, for example, is people eat cooked ham on Easter Sunday. So what defines an active sentence? So in an active sentence, the subject does the action. The subject acts upon its verb. So here we have people, and what do? People eat ham. And on the other hand, if we have a passive sentence, now we have the same thing, just said in a different way. Cooked ham is eaten on Easter Sunday. In a passive sentence, the subject, here it is cooked ham, isn't doing anything. The subject here is receiving the action. So it is a recipient of a verb's action. So it is not the ham that is eating. A ham is eaten on Easter Sunday. So what is important here for us to know? It is important to know the structure of every sentence. So every sentence has a subject, it has an object and a verb. And we have to know how to find the subject, how to find the object and the verb. So this is a typical normal verb order in a sentence. So we have my father washes the car every Sunday. What is my father? My father, of course, is the subject. The subject is normally at the beginning of the sentence. Then after the subject normally comes the verb. And then after the verb comes the object of the sentence. And then in the end, of course, we can have adverbials of time and place. But this is normal. Subject, verb, and object. So, what does this have to do with our passive forms? So, how to form a passive sentence? We have to go through three steps to make a passive sentence. And the first step has to do with these parts of the sentence. So, in the first step, we have to change the object of the active sentence into subject of the passive sentence. Okay, so object becomes the subject. So, let's take a look at an example. People visit the science museum every day. The science museum here is the object of the sentence. So in a passive sentence, we are going to begin with the science museum. The science museum is visited every day. So this is going to be the passive sentence. Or Columbus discovered America in 1492. Here America is the object. So in the passive sentence, we will have America was discovered in 1492 by Columbus. So this was our first step, to change the object into the subject. The second step is to change the verb form. So we need to use the passive verb form. And how are we form the passive verb form? We are going to use the verb to be. And in the present simple, we will use am, are, is. And in past simple, we will use was and were, and something called the past participle of the main verb. So we already know what is the past participle, but if you forgot, For regular verbs, the past participle ends in ed, so like washed, discovered, invited, lived, smiled, played. And for irregular verbs, it is the third form that we learned by heart. So if we had make, made, made, buy, bought, bought, go, went, gone. Okay, so we will need the third form of the verb. So for example, in the present simple, if we have something like wash or washes, it's going to change into MR is washed. So we will choose MR is depending on the subject. And for past simple, okay, so we have one typical past simple verb, discovered. It is going to change into was or were discovered, again, depending on the subject. So this was the second step, change the verb form. And finally, the third step. So what to do with the subject of the active sentence? So the subject of the active becomes doer of the action in the passive sentence. The doer is introduced with by only if it is important, if it is a specific person. But if it's not important, if we don't know who is the subject, if it's obvious, if we have something like people, somebody, they, so nothing specific, it is not given. We are not going to introduce it by people, by somebody, or by them. So we are not going to use that. So one more time, the subject becomes the doer of the action. Like, my father washes the car. My father is the subject here. And in the passive is going to be the car is washed by my father. My father is a specific person, so we are introducing the doer. But in this case, somebody broke the window. Somebody is not specific. We don't know who that somebody is. So we are just going to say the window was broken. Okay, now let's make passive sentences. So in the first step, let's make the present simple passive. So just using MR is plus the past participle. Let's take a look at the picture. We have coffee in Colombia. So what happens to coffee in Colombia? People produce coffee in Colombia. Let's take a look at the passive sentence. So we will start with coffee. We are going to change the verb from produce into is produced. And finally, in Colombia. We are not adding by people because this is not a specific person. Okay, next one. What happens to apples in Canada? People grow apples in Canada in the passive form. It is apples are grown in Canada. Okay, next one. Bananas in Brazil. People sell bananas in Brazil in the passive form. Bananas are sold in Brazil. And one more. We have rice in China. People import rice from China. And in the passive form, it will be rice is imported from China. So one more time, just use are, is, or am, and use the past participle of the form of the verb. And now let's make past simple passive. So everything is the same. We are just using was and were. So we have dynamite by Alfred Nobel. Alfred Nobel invented dynamite. So the past simple passive will be dynamite was invented by Alfred Nobel. Next one. A novel by Charles Dickens. Charles Dickens wrote the novel Oliver Twist. And the passive form? The novel Oliver Twist was written by Charles Dickens. Okay. Or The Theory of Relativity by Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein discovered the theory of relativity. In the passive, the theory of relativity was discovered by Albert Einstein. And the last one. Okay, we have airplanes and the Wright brothers. The Wright brothers made the first airplanes. In the passive, the first airplanes were made by the Wright brothers. Okay, so these were the examples, and now it's your turn. So this is your task to do in Teams. Make your own passive sentence, present or past, and write it in the comment section. So write it in Teams under this announcement. So write your own passive sentence, present or past. And this was it. Thank you for watching and see you again with